why not allow that building permit to pick that cost, or the DC to pick that up, and just know that when a building permit is triggered, and DC pays that, the bills are due. I can't understand why you would want to be back and forth with the property owner. Can you help me?
So, that will be, because some property owners do build their own houses and so on, that'll be a decision of the developer, if they want to take on, because there's not only the cost of bins, but there's the water meter. Our development committee is talking about that right now, how we're going to handle it. White Rose may handle it different, but that's their decision. But at the end of the day, the part of getting town occupancy will be having a water meter, having an address on your house, or a 911 blade at the road, or having, and having blue cards.
Barbara?
We don't send them an invoice. You know, the kids get added to their tax bill, right?
Again, that's up to the situation. We, if it's a developer going to do it, we would work with them and build them for it, or do a building permit stage, or whatever. That's up to them. They won't get final occupancy, or they won't be able to be in the house.
So, if I may, I just want to take the opportunity to further appreciate the presence of Mr. Kurtz with us. On slide 11, it states, in addition to the system review that we talked about earlier, it talks about municipal servicing standards update. So, we not too long ago, like within the last year, 18 months, established updated municipal servicing standards. And do we anticipate that we're going to continue to need to update that? Like, is that a 5-year cycle thing? How does that work?
I don't think there's a fixed time. I think that it should be done as the need arises. And I think with all this development going on, we got the municipal standards updated for the start of this development, but as we're working through the development, we're finding certain things that are maybe lacking or not detailed enough. So we're making notes of, as we're going along. I've been, discussing this with Jim as to when's a good time, and I'm sort of thinking, let's wait until we get sort of through the first phase of some of these developments and see what all comes out of it, and then we'll incorporate some of the details that we need, that we feel that we need to. But that doesn't mean that we can't enforce some of these items that we think we need in the meantime. The municipality still has the discretion to do that.
Whether it's in your current approved standards or not?
That's right.
Okay. Jim?
So just a quick example of that is last June when we did that update, we included the section with LED lighting, which was pretty robust to the standard. But now, all of a sudden, as the development started to come at us, we went and changed and replaced LED to 2000K. That was our standard. So again, that was a little bit of shortcoming talking with the developer in the initial stages, because they started ordering 4000K. So luckily enough, we were able to nip it in the bud, and they agreed to go to 3000K, which is what the rest of the municipalities. But that is one of the examples that caught us, and we'll be bringing an update sooner than later.
Any additional questions, comments? So, in the absence of any further direction, you're going to bring back pretty much the same structure of DC bylaw we did last time, and it's just going to be updated with these current numbers.
That's correct. And just the addition of the version, the only additional service.
Okay, so maybe, one last question. We went from 10 to 15, now 10 to 18, and we have the impact of new DC legislation, and we also have the impact of more growth. Like, in principle, if you have more users to spread the expense over, in this case, more residences, shouldn't that be lower? There's a principle that I'm not catching there.
It is in some cases, so if you look at that impact slide for roads, for example, you'll see that the charge for roads is going down compared, on the next slide. So from 2961 to 2293.
But we added 2 million.
Right, but you've added more, you've added twice the development. So to your point, even though we've added more costs, we've added more growth than cost, and just put down the pressure on that rate. The reason why water and wastewater is going up more significantly is because we've added more cost than we've added growth. Right, principally with wastewater, removing the ISBIM grant funding down to 25% to put more cost above what we have in development, increase in development.
So to your point about water and wastewater, where we added more, rephrase that?
So you've added more costs than you've added additional development.
Right, and my concern is that the manifestation of that is going to be an increased hit to the actual users at some point, but we can't predict that.
Not necessarily. If you're referring to the hit to the users being the existing ratepayers?
Yes. Water and sewer users.
Right, then it would be a matter of, has that cost increase been borne by new development, we've seen with an increase in the DC, or has it also increased the benefit to existing, which is what's getting paid for by the existing rate payer. Right, so go back to that wastewater treatment plant discussion earlier.
Mm-hmm.
One thing we were looking at earlier was that benefit to existing cost was higher in the 2010 study than what's being proposed now. And that would have been built into your previous rate study before. So as we were talking about earlier, we have to go back and look at the amount of rate-based funding for that project that was built into that previous water and wastewater rate study to measure its impact. And it would suggest that it's probably a downward pressure on rates as opposed to upward pressure from this change.
Thank you for that. So there's been discussion about a potential date for the public meeting, and I'm not sure that we're ready to commit to that. The staff would know better. Are you going to be joining us for that meeting?
Yes.
Very good. Any other questions at this time? Barbara?
Through the chair, I'm looking at the resolution and just the deeper information. Is there any other direction that this committee of the whole needs to discuss? What is the resolution coming out of the committee of the whole to trigger the prepare the formal DC background study and draft bylaws? Is there a resolution, or is this we receive it for information and we just carry on?
My interpretation is you're going to bring back the same structure, the same exemption, everything the same, different numbers, unless we direct you otherwise.
What we will do is we'll post the document next week on the website, and then if we can get it into the council agenda, which I would hope, we will post that in the council agenda for information. To get it out there and then do the advertising public meeting, and then December 15th would be the approval date, 60 days. So the goal will be to get posted before 15th of September.
And that's, do I dare mention October 11th as the possible date?
Sure.
Okay, so October 11th is the targeted public meeting
is
date.
Is possibly, yeah, we'll confirm that. That's okay. Also 9 o'clock in the morning is a budget meeting. So we do the DC public meeting at 1, unless we change our mind and try and slip in early, like at 9 and follow it with capital, but we'll see.
Barbara?
Is there any way to, I understand the urgency with making sure that we keep this moving forward, because without it, building permits could be issued and we will not be collecting the new DC charges. But is there any way to have a second public meeting on the evening? Or how does it have to be a public meeting on a Wednesday?
It doesn't have to be a public meeting on a Wednesday, but by and large, your developers are working, that's their business. So
questions, comments? Okay, so we've had a lengthy discussion about feeding this for information, and the clerk informs me that anybody who is not here will move in second of that motion will not be required to vote. So any further discussion on the resolution? All those in favor of receiving for information? So we discount the two council members, so carried. And now, we need a resolution that committee adjourn as committee of the whole and resume the council meeting. Who would like to move that? Christine and Barbara, discussion on that? All those in favor?
635.
Okay, and, sorry, all those in favor? Carried. Motion resulting from committee of the whole, be resolved that council confirms the resolutions as presented and passed during the committee of the whole meeting on September 6, 2017. Who would like to move that? Jim and John, discussion? All those in favor? You can vote on that.
You don't want me to vote one, but you want me to vote another.
No, it's perfect, it's all there. Okay, so, that's carried. And then confirming bylaw, be resolved that bylaw 2017-115, being a bylaw to confirm the proceedings of the council of corporation of the township of Southgate, a special meeting held September 6, 2017, be read the first, second, third time, finally passed, signed by the mayor and clerk, sealed with the seal of corporation and entered into the bylaw book. And who would like to move that? Christine? Barbara, discussion? All those in favor? Carried. So moves, we move?
If we can.
All those in favor? Carried.
We'll check with the clerk.
What was the reason that couldn't?
Because you weren't here when you were moving.
You weren't here when we moved and seconded.
You arrived late, so not.
Moved and seconded to go into a whole meeting.
No.